I literally can't think of a better way to start the next 100 episodes of Daily V than this amazing email from Andre and using his entire mashup video as episode 1001 as a recap of where we together have gotten in the last 100 episodes onto another 100 episodes, my friends. Before I go into this, by show of hands, how many people here have no idea who I am or anything about my spiel? Tell the truth, raise them. That fucking hurts. I get thousands of emails a week. How do I find my passion? And literally I reply, I don't know. I would tell you my punchline is, what would you do if you could just do it all the time?
Everybody is the happiest when they get to do what they want to be doing. When you get to do what you want to do, you've won. That is the seductive nature of entrepreneurship. But there's a problem. There's a naivete in the world that just because you talk, people are going to listen. You actually have to be good. How do you stay driven? I'm going to ask you a question. How don't you stay driven? You won the lotto of the universe, which is you are a human being on earth. And you're not driven, and you're not fired up, and you're willing to sit like a lump and just wait till you die, you suck. Cause we're gonna be legends. I don't know what everybody, like, you're gonna be 90, and you're gonna look back, and what? This is it. I mean, there's just so much complaining, there's so much cynicism, there's so much you got lucky, there's so much, everybody just wants to point at other people. Point your fucking self. At the end of the day, it's gonna be what it's gonna be. It all comes down to 20, 30, 40 years from now. Like what? It's just results. How did the people around you feel about you? How much did you create? What impact did you have on people? It's the money. It's the fame. It's the impact you've had on people. It's the way your family thinks about you. It's the way your best friends think about you. You can be a fucking ninja entrepreneur and you can be an awesome person and give back to society. You can do both if you've got the talent. That is the game.
If you're good enough, if you are good enough to be up here, to make bling bling, if you are good enough, nobody's stopping you. Nobody. If you are a minority, if you are a female, if you are a transgender, if you're a fucking alien, the market doesn't give a fuck. If you make the best shit, you will win.
If anybody has ever made it that looks like you, then you can too. And what's harder, much harder, than getting money or respect from the establishment is actually winning with the market. When somebody will say to me, well, Gary, I can't get funding because I'm a girl, or I can't get funding because I'm from Mexico. Bro, it's way harder to actually have your product win with customers than to get some old white dudes on Sand Hill Road to write you a check. So if this is breaking you down, if you're crying now, you're in deep fucking shit. The market makes old white dudes that are racist seem soft. Look, if you want something to happen, you can't just visualize it. This isn't the secret shit. Everybody should live their lives the way they want to, but if you want to build something big, if you want to create a big business, hard work is the first, second, and third part of the formula. When you have the audacity to be an entrepreneur and own your own business and want all the riches and great things that come with it, you need to put in the work. I promise you, if you look at your 8 hours every day, 2 to 3 of them, you're spending on dumb shit. Work is the variable of success. Work. You don't know a single person on earth that's successful that didn't put in work. Nobody watching this right now knows a single person that became successful without the work. You know what I feel? I feel an epic rant. I feel like I have to do a fucking rant. So I'm in good spirits. We'll see what happens today.
If you work in a job, you are not an entrepreneur. Now, I know that hurts, and I'm gonna say it again. If you right now, as you're running through the airport or driving on the highway, are going to a job, you, my friend, are not an entrepreneur.
Like, you can't just decide you're gonna be an entrepreneur. You can. There's a big difference between being an entrepreneur and having entrepreneurial tendencies and actually being a successful entrepreneur. The punchline is this. Way too many people are playing it half-time. You either do it or you don't. There is no in-betweens. This is binary. You didn't think it was true that they were 15, 16 hours a day. You thought they were hyperbolized and they were 8 or 9. You didn't realize every minute was something. You didn't realize that it's every day, always, forever. When you're playing a different game, you gotta also eat the shit that comes along with it. It's super fun to fucking be an entrepreneur 21 and play the game. If you fucking lose, you lose. Don't give up, we'll put you down. Recognize that you can attack the world in a totally different way because you were lucky enough to be born during this era. Every time there is an actual attention revolution, enormous money is made and enormous money is lost. Just because you weren't first doesn't mean you can't be best. When you're in do mode, you fucking get shit done. What do you think about that? I can tell you what to do. A screwdriver works. But if you don't go and do it, then that screwdriver sucks shit. A lot of people look at finished products. They look at LeBron today. They look at Kobe today. They look at Beyonce today. If I'm sitting on a couch and I'm like, oh, that athlete thinks they're so fancy, I wasn't there for the last 22 years that they woke up at 5 o'clock in the morning to get them to this moment.
You have to deal with the reality of the situation. Dwelling and pondering and crying doesn't do shit. You can cry, you're just gonna lose. And I have bad news about complaining and crying. Nobody gives a shit. Listen to me.
Nobody's gonna feel sorry for you. Who's gonna feel sorry for you? I'll tell you who's gonna feel sorry for you. Oh, you know who feels sorry for you? Your other enabling losing players around you. It's just one fucking losing circle. Either you're hanging out with people that are dragging you down or you're hanging out with people that are lifting you up. But I promise you this, every winner in your life has zero sympathy for you.
Well, don't you just walk away?
I just think that people are scared to fail in front of other people. My friends, I'm telling you something right now. I'm desperately excited to fail in front of you. Because A, I don't really give a fuck what you think. B, I'm gonna learn from it. And C, battle scars are attractive. Speed is 4 billion times more important than perfection. The amount of you that are crippled by getting shit right instead of getting shit done is insane. We're living in a world where there's so much more opportunity. This internet thing created way more opportunity for all of us, way more. Like, I don't give a fuck if you think I'm the greatest and fucking the messiah, or if you think I'm a piece of shit con artist. I'll see you in 2020, 2030, 2040. I'll see you. I'll fucking see you. Please, take a step back and think about how awesome it actually is.
What you gonna do with your life?
You know, being successful takes several different variables. I think self-awareness is number one. If you don't know yourself and you don't know what you're good at, you've got no shot because you're gonna be spinning your wheels. Like, are you willing to be super honest with yourself when nobody's watching? Mm-hmm. We all know who we are. Yeah. Sometimes we don't like that.
What are you actually good at? What do you like doing? Because the opportunities are endless. The problem is we are scared to do different things because the fundamental core reality is we worry about what other people think. We worry about getting judged if we fail.
Like, if you're not your number one fan, you've lost. Because the market's really good at tearing you down.
Every day, 24/7, 365, I will remind you that life is phenomenal. That nobody gives a shit. So the government or your mommy's not gonna help you. You've gotta do it, own your shit, but it's never been better. We've got a bigger chance than ever. We can do our thing.
We are strong as shit. We're really fucking strong. We're just being sold that we're not. Because there's a lot of money in telling us that we're not pretty enough, thin enough, smart enough, good enough. Fuck that. I want to tell you, you're the fucking best. Go do shit. I just want it so bad for you. I want it bad for you. I believe that you can. And by the way, I'm not like, anybody can do it. Like, some of you suck. Some of you don't have the skills. Why do you think I talk about self-awareness? I just want you to try hard at the thing that you may naturally be best at, because that's where everybody finds their moment. How much more motivation do fuckers need? Like, you live one life, it goes fast. Life goes fast.
The problem for so many of you, the reason so few things are happening for a lot of people is they're confused. They don't know what they want. They want 8,000 things. They're just confused. Stop being confused. Figure out what you want, reverse engineer it, and get it.
The biggest poison in us is regret. It's poison.
Everybody here is already sitting with 2, 3, 4 things they can think of very quickly that they regret right now, already. And right now you feel okay because you got a lot of life to go. But if you spend time with people in their 80s and 90s, the thing they will absolutely teach you if you really dig is regret fucking sucks.
When you see regret in a man's eyes, it's fucking painful because you can't do shit about it. When you're 90 and you're not mobile and you're tired and it's over, you can't do it. You can't do it. You can't build that company you wanted. You can't spend that time with your kid. It's regret and it fucking drives the shit out of you.
What would you do if you could just do it all the time?
The only decision that needs to be made is the one that you will regret the least when you're 90.
All my advice is only for the complainers. This is only for the complainers. I'm not mad at you if you play Madden. I'm not mad at you if you watch fucking Lost. I'm not mad at you if you watch complete seasons of House of Cards. I'm not mad at you if you play Call of Duty all day. I'm mad at you if you're doing that and you're baffled and complaining why you're not making more money and why you're not living your dreams.
Gotta have a dream, but you've gotta be practical.
The world isn't what mommy and daddy told you. The world is exactly going to be what it's going to be, with or without the way you thought it was going to be. A ton of shit is going to change. The world changes every goddamn day.
It's equally fucking pushing it as it's being patient. And if you push from those two extremes, you fucking make shit. Everybody's on one extreme or the other. That's why the people that push from both extremes win. That's why there's so few people that win. Like, I have a dirty little secret for you. Doing the right thing is always the right thing. Like, it has a funny, like, call it fucking karma, call it whatever the shit the fuck you want. Doing the right thing is the right thing.
The work, it trumps everything. It's the one non-debatable. You can debate talent, you can debate luck, you can debate circumstance. You can't debate if somebody's putting in the work. Not subjective, motherfuckers. You either put in the 15, 16, 18 hours of work that gives you the best position to succeed in what you're trying to achieve, or you don't.
I just don't get the mentality of being head down sad on a Monday morning.
And a lot of people need to hear one of two things today, which is, this is the greatest era to ever be alive and be an entrepreneur or executive if you want it, and stop complaining and dwelling because nobody gives a fuck. Thank you.
Feeling good. Yes. Feeling good. Productive. 24/7, 365.
So that's it. Couldn't have gone better for me. Having somebody out of the blue make an incredible piece of content to wrap up what this is really about, which is as much about you guys as it is me, this community, the comment section, watching what's happening in the comment section. I just love it, and so I just want to say thank you. Please subscribe. Please pass this on to somebody that needs to be part of this journey. This would be the time, and I'll see you tomorrow. This is a grinder of a week. Chicago, more filming in LA. It's going to be good stuff. I think you'll enjoy it. See ya.